everybody. I'm Larry Ridley. This is Madden 18 on EA Sports. Anticipation is mounting for today's game, and we've got two quarterbacks looking to make an impact. It's Roethlisberger's Steelers going up against Newton's Panthers.
All right, Larry, EA Sports coverage of the NFL finds us at Bank of America Stadium in Uptown Charlotte. Just a moment ago, the lights, the cameras, the action, all the pyrotechnics, everything was ablaze, everything was allowed here in Bank of America Stadium as Carolina emerged from their tunnel. And we are ready to go as the Panthers get set to match up with Ben Roethlisberger and the Pittsburgh Steelers. Has it first and 10. Now a first carry for Jonathan Stewart. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down. Boy, that's a lot of sirloin steak to be taken down for no gain, partner.
Are you trying to suggest that he is a huge man?
He is.
Not just a big man,
big,
a huge man.
Big, big boy.
Well, how about the credit then for the defense to be able to chop that big tree and put him on the ground?
I know back when you played, it took four of you to take a guy like that down, right?
Well, that's for sure. And you know what else? I didn't want to challenge him at dinner either.
That first good for 20 and a first down. Gained 13 yards that time and another first down. So here we go, first and 10 now. Back to throw, Newton. And this one complete right side to Funches. And he'll take it down here just shy of the 15 at the 16-yard line. A gain of 6 there on first. I don't think it's a surprise they're throwing the football early. We expected that. They told us they were going to come out firing, but 4 for 4 on the opening drive. They like that.
They don't just like it. They love it because now everyone gets locked in. Your confidence jumps up. Everyone's easy about what they're doing out there. And by the way, they're looking at the sidelines thinking to themselves and expressing, let's keep throwing it. We're doing pretty well.
Two-yard line now. It's first and goal. Stewart. And he is not going to get through here on try number one. They stop him at the goal line. Call it no gain, and it's going to be second and goal.
He's going to sneak it.
Offense walks to the line for play number 7 of the drive. Now it's the power game. Young, the fullback. And he is in. Touchdown, Carolina. Darrell Young punching it in from a yard away. And the Panthers take it right down and score on the opening drive. And this will be good to give the Panthers a 7-0 lead. Gonneau out to kick this one away. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And he's able to get it across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked down at the 21-yard line. Now the first carry for Le'Veon Bell. And he'll take it ahead to the 28-yard line. A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a 2nd and 3. If these kinds of lanes are available, you have to feel like he's going to have a pretty big game on the ground.
Yeah, you can tell early on he's got a little burst in his step, and that's a big pickup right there on first down.
On 2nd down, it's Bell. And this time he's not going anywhere. They'll get him down right at the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain that time as it's going to leave him with a 3rd and about 3 to go. Now the defense definitely showing blitz here. Back with Charles Davis, Brandon Gaudin. It's Steeler football to begin quarter number 2. They'll face a 3rd down conversion attempt here, 3rd and 3. Shotgun, it's Roethlisberger. He gets it to Brown, complete. And he'll be out of bounds up past the 45. A good pick up there of 20 yards. And connection number 1 there on the game, Roethlisberger to Boney Tony. Antonio Brown, that's what his high school teammates used to call him.
I wonder what they would call him now.
More muscular, more successful Boney Tony Brown, right?
I'd say you're probably right. It may be all of that. I'll still call him Boney Tony, but Ben Roethlisberger calls him my number 1 target.
Now a 1st down carry by Bell. Room to run inside the 40. And he gets this one all the way down inside the 20-yard line. A big play on the ground there. It goes for 36 yards.
Boy, he does it at a high level, doesn't he? Because when I watch him, I think of his vision. Straight ahead, peripheral. Also has that sense of where holes are going to be before they actually open. I think that helps set him apart from many of the other bats in the league.
And he's going to find his way forward here for a modest gain. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be 2nd down.
And when you get good yardage like that on 1st down, it really does a whole lot of good for your entire offense. But I love the way he's finishing those runs. At the end of things, he's making sure he gets just a little bit extra.
A fake to Bell. Now it's Roethlisberger. Eluding the pressure right.
Gotcha, anybody.
It's caught. It's Brown.
Took forever to get over there.
Touchdown, Steelers. Antonio Brown, an 11-yard touchdown. And the Steelers are an extra point away from tying this thing up.
It's actually playing on defense as well.
So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. That's fielded in the end zone. And now running right through it. And they'll have excellent field position to begin this drive as he's all the way up to midfield at the 50. Charles, I want to go back to something you said earlier in the broadcast as the Panthers come back out. You talked about Cam Newton having a guy like Christian McCaffrey to take some pressure off of him. Expand on that. What did you mean?
They don't want him to stay in the pocket and take as many hits as he has in the past. So they want the ball out of his hands quicker. And Christian McCaffrey
gives
him
throw it to him from the slot.
Swing out of the backfield. He does all of those things. Jonathan Stewart is the incumbent number 1 running back. But Christian McCaffrey will get plenty of touches in 2017.
From the 50, Newton. Caught on the left side by Benjamin.
Oh, my gosh, really, Mike Mitchell?
Touchdown, Carolina. Calvin Benjamin, 50 yards. And the Panthers have taken the lead. As a former DB, you might not like to see that, but from a wide receiver's perspective, those are the plays they dream of.
Correct on both counts. All right? Because once he took off, I mean, let's face it, That should have been done in Big Sky Country. Aren't any speed limits out there? And off he went. Glad I wasn't the one trying to chase him.
The Steelers' offense now, they head back onto the field. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
What to say, though. Drop a pick, next play's a touchdown.
On first down, it's Roethlisberger. And he'll toss this one incomplete. Seeing no options, he throws it away.
The one thing that I've liked defensively is that they've shown him a lot of different looks here in the first half. They've come after him, they've sat back. I think that's what you need to do to keep an offense guessing.
And they certainly have kept them on their toes. That's why they haven't had much success on the scoreboard. Second and 10 now. It's Roethlisberger. And this is caught by Martavis Bryant. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. The Steeler first down. Roethlisberger to Bryant. They go play action here on first down.
Wow.
Fires one that's intercepted.
Okay.
Picked off by Mike Adams. And the return stops at the 39-yard line.
Brandon, I'm not going to tell him that you called him old in our pregame meeting, but this guy has been around a long time. If there's a trick in the book, he knows it. He probably even wrote a few chapters. And this is what he's always had. And that's a nose for the football. He's able to come away here with the interception.
Now following the interception, here's Newton.
Oh,
nearly a disaster there on the check down. But they'll get it back. And so they just got the football on an interception. They almost gave it right back the same way.
And you know, when you look over to the bench after that type of a play, number one is pure relief. Didn't give it up. But it's not the coach you're worried about yelling at you. It's those guys on defense who just intercepted the pass who want a break over there. Hey, take care of the football, man.
On the catch, this is Russell Shepherd. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this into enemy territory across the 40. A good pickup there, a 22. Newton on first down. They'll set up the screen for Stewart. And he's going to get it down to the 33-yard line here. A nice little screen. They get six on first down.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass. Looked like it was coming together. Looked like there was an opening. Still ended up with a solid game.
Throwing again is Newton. So Shepherd complete over the middle.
Hey,
he gets us all the way down inside the 15. A good pickup there of 20 yards.
And when you're playing a quarterback with some experience and some moxie, you enter the danger zone when you decide to blitz him, because if he's able to diagnose as he did on that play, he can hurt you downfield.
He reads defenses so well, doesn't he?
He really does, and the best part about that play for him, I don't think that was his primary target.
I don't think so either.
I think he had the read, figured out where the blitz was coming from, and went to a secondary target for a really nice game.
Now the defense going to use the first of their timeouts. So as they take it over, we step aside. And they're definitely showing blitz here. First and goal from the one as they look to punch it in. And they will stop him after a fairly minimal pickup. And the Steelers signal for another timeout. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. Newton takes it himself. And I don't think he got in. The big bodies up front held him at the one.
Now, that was a little too conservative for my liking. It's only second down, and they try to run the sneak. Give credit to the defense. They pushed them back and set up third down.
Now the Panthers get set, third and goal.
And the defense has to account for Cam Newton on this play.
They come out here in the eye, trying to punch it in. Stewart, and he takes it into the end zone for a Panthers touchdown. Jonathan Stewart taking it in for a pick. And the Panthers add on to their lead. It's good, and it is now 21-7. Gano out to kick this one away. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. Out comes the Steeler offense now, ready to see what they can do here. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time. Do you try something?
You're thinking about jump-starting your team, right? You just mentioned they're down. They're trying to get back into the game. But you got to figure, if something goes wrong, you may have put yourself in a spot where you may not be able to come back in the second half. Managing risk, this is a big decision here.
It'll be a gain of 17 at a Pittsburgh first. They'll throw on first down with Roethlisberger. And he slings one that's incomplete. Antonio Brown, the intended receiver, and it's second down.
Let's face it, if you want to get back into the game, these are the kind of throws you got to hit. He's wide open right there. Got to be able to get it to him, don't you think?
And those are the throws that haven't been available to them every time he's dropped a pass. Yeah, that's a big miss. Bryant with a catch right side. The passing game in rhythm right now for Pittsburgh. There's another first down. First down now, but the clock continues to move. And now the passing game here in the second quarter starting to heat up a little bit.
Don't you feel the rhythm starting to happen, right? You see it now. The confidence is starting to run.
No escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Julius Peppers.
I had him too.
In there to sack him for a loss of six. On second down, here's Roethlisberger. He's going deep for Brown. Got his man, it's caught for a Steelers touchdown. Antonio Brown, as time expires in the first half, and the Steelers have now made this a one-score game. It's up and good. This becomes a 21-14 ball game now. We have hit halftime. Still two more quarters to go. We'll take a timeout. We'll be back after this. You're watching the NFL, and it's on EA Sports.
It's in the game.
So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number three. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. The Steeler offense now with a football first here to begin the third quarter. They're down here, but very much in this game. What's the tonality of a coach's talk when a game is within striking distance like this at intermission?
Typically, what they're doing is emphasizing the things that went well in the first half and wanting more of that. Sure, you've got to go over some of the errors and clean up some things because there's a reason you're down. But overall, I think they want to stay positive, stay up with this team. We're just starting the second half, and we've got the football. Let's go ahead and punch it in, and then we'll take it from there.
See how that recipe works. And he's able to get this one up to the 45-yard line. A good pick up there of 20 yards. Here on first down, he's gonna fire this thing deep right sideline. So he took a shot on first down but couldn't connect.
And you just know when that play call came in, their eyes lit up, because anytime you get a chance to take a big shot downfield, that's a lot of fun, and they missed an opportunity.
Second and 10, it's Roethlisberger once more, flushed out right. Now he'll let it go deep over the middle. And that's caught inside the 30. He got 29 yards that time. A great job pulling that one in from a guy, as we know, who can really blaze. He's got a lot of speed.
And that speed can work for him so many different ways. Sometimes he just takes off and goes and just runs past people. Sometimes you get people to back off so far that you can catch everything underneath. But still, at some point in the game, you probably have to make some contested catches, right? Sometimes you have to go up and beat a defender for the football. He has that in his arsenal as well.
Showed it right there. And he's brought down. They get 10 more there, and I believe that'll be enough for another first down. It will.
The more football I watch, the more I want to check and see if teams are going to panic when they're down on the scoreboard. And this team has shown no signs of doing that. A lot of the time, they come out after the half. Things haven't worked so well in the first go-around. They want to throw the football like crazy. But the way to open up throwing the ball is to run it. And they've run it well here to start the second half.
Completed pass play. Now let's see if they go back to the air or to the ground. Roethlisberger with a give to Bell. And he'll be brought down here at the 3-yard line. 7 yards on the pickup there, and now they've got it first and goal.
So many teams want to throw the ball in this situation nowadays, but I love watching a team that has enough confidence to go ahead and run the football in that situation. That's almost a tendency breaker.
They'll try and run it in with Bell. And he's going to get this back to the 3-yard line and no further. No gain on the play that time, and it sets up second and goal. A well-executed blitz, no doubt. Great job by the linebacker. Maybe the quarterback, if he could have seen that, would have audible. Gotcha. That will be caught by James. The big tight end has a Steeler touchdown. Jesse James from 3 yards out. And the Steelers are an extra point away from tying this thing up. Boswell for the extra point. He's got it, and we're all tied at 21. So we're right back where we started. All even as the kick's away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And a big hit at the end of that one. He's knocked down hard. The Panthers offense now, they head back on the field for their first possession of the second half. First half showed us some pretty good offense. Tie game, we'll see what the second half brings.
And it'll be interesting because I think both sides feel pretty good about what their offenses are doing. Gotta wonder what adjustments are being made defensively to try and get a spark and maybe slow down the other side.
But here, do you change up anything on this opening drive?
Not offensively, you don't. You got everything going your way. You've probably prepared for maybe some change-ups you might expect, but overall, you like what your game plan's showing you.
Now problems right out of the gate. We're gonna get a delay. He didn't even try to signal for a timeout, so they must have not been aware of the numbers.
I think he lost track of the time left in the play clock and probably was trying to read the defense and trying to figure out which play to run and just lost track, and it cost him.
A shotgun snap for Newton. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
That would have been a great catch, but it's real difficult to hold on to it because it was contested all the way. Would have been a great play if he had been able to haul that one in.
To throw on second down is Newton. And Olsen over the middle.
Jesus Christ, Greg Olsen getting 6 yards of separation. Game.
A good pickup there at 22.
We've been together a little while now, partner. How often do we actually describe tight ends as nifty? Because that's what I think of when I see Greg Olsen on the field. His ability to run routes, create space and separation, and make those catches downfield.
Yeah, sure consistent. The numbers the last couple years almost identical, and both over 1,000-yard seasons. Offense looking to avoid a third and long. It's second and 10. Throwing again. Newton.
Oh, my gosh. Come on.
Intercepted it. They haven't picked a ball off yet. That probably should have been their first. And it's third down now.
Close. It's close, coach.
And on third down, a nickel formation here defensively. Again, Newton.
Got that.
Rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by Ryan
Shazier.
And he's able to get it back to the 33-yard line.
Oh, timing is everything. I'm just going to keep dropping, man. He tried to drive that football into a tight spot. And if you're a little early or a little late, chances are there's going to be someone there. And sure enough, this one's going the other way.
After the interception, here's
Roethlisberger.
Rush coming and
really?
Taken down.
Engage eight.
Look, Carolina had a number of issues last year, and that's why they slumped to 6-10 after a Super Bowl appearance. But pass rush wasn't a problem for them. They still got to the quarterback.
47 total sacks. That was just one behind Arizona, who led the league.
Yeah, I think the biggest issue for them, young corners, they gave up a lot of big plays.
Now Roethlisberger to throw on second down.
Oh my gosh, that's terrible. Throw.
Picked by Darryl Worley. Oh, and now he bowls him over. And the return
terrible
stops just a few yards shy of midfield. He'll spot the ball at the 47-yard line.
Brandon, this is a veteran quarterback back there. He should know better than to make a throw like this. This is definitely not his best ball. And I think he knew this was trouble the second it was leaving his hand.
Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw.
I'll take that.
And some room to work.
And we'll house it.
And he's in for six and a Steeler touchdown. Well, we know this defense has athleticism. Spots like that prove us right.
I love the way that you spotlighted the athleticism because you and I
fourth
both
fourth time you've thrown that route.
The best athletes on the
or
field,
someone adjusts.
They play on defense.
Oh, I don't know. I was a kicker. You got to remember that now.
Come on. Come on.
Fine. Extra point now by Boswell. And it's good. That makes it a 28-21 game. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And he'll bring it a few past the 20 to the 23-yard line. Here come the Panthers now set to take over on offense. And the points, they have come fast and furious in this quarter.
You really don't want to be on the defensive side of the ball right now, do you? Because you're either thinking, my replacement may get an opportunity.
Your head better be on a swivel.
Totally. Or maybe I just need to get out of the game for a while because I just can't slow these guys down. They've got to figure out a way to disrupt these offenses. And typically, one guy makes a big play, and that can help change things.
They'll be looking for disruption on both sides right now. So the incomplete pass brings up second down. To throw again. Newton escaping the pressure right.
Play down.
And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down.
Play
Cameron
down.
Hayward. He's the one that got to him.
Trying
he
to get
takes
that wheel
him down
so
for a loss
down.
Of nine. So now Cam leads the Panthers up following the sack. Carolina facing third and long. From the gun, here's Newton. Flush to his right.
Serious?
And some big time hitting going on there. He is knocked to the ground at the 44-yard line.
Still ran right by 7 yards.
That one goes for 29 yards on third down.
I'll take that, man. Get out of here.
Cam Newton intercepted a third time. Picked off by Ryan Shazier. And he's just across midfield and down at the 49-yard line. Now Roethlisberger going to hand to Bell. And he'll get this down only to about the 46. Give him three on first down. It'll set up a second and seven.
Brandon, you know how many times we've done games, and at the start of the fourth quarter, we see both teams hold up the four fingers, fourth quarter is ours. Well, how about this drive? You saw the four fingers for four-minute offense, and this offensive line has really hunkered down and established themselves.
Now, this is where they say, put the game on our shoulders, we'll lead the way, right?
No doubt about it, and let me tell you, if you're a running back, all you want to do is get behind those big fellas, have a little vision, and find some space.
And a solid way to do that on the first play of the drive there. He's got a man. It's his fullback.
Oh, and yes.
He gets this one perfect all the way dot. Down inside the 20-yard
perfect
line.
Perfect dot.
That one, 28 yards on the ground. This is something you got to be wary of defensively. I mean, just because they're in the mode of trying to burn some clock doesn't mean they won't pass it, and they got good yardage out of that one.
Yeah, and really, when you're looking at it, now they've got a fresh set of
just
downs.
Run some clock off.
Look for second down. If they want to take another shot and try and loosen things up, that'd be the time to do it.
In the red zone this time. Here's Bell. And he'll get about three as he's taken down at the 14-yard line. Able to stay in bounds, and the clock keeps rolling. And this defense right now backed up in the red zone. Another touchdown, it's over. They've got to stand tall quickly.
Been in this spot before. Now there's a little bit of desperation creeping in. And all you're doing when you're talking to your defensive teammates is, first guy there, hold him up. Second, third guy in, rake it the football. Get it out. We've got to create a turnover because one more score, and this game's over.
And the offense here just looking to stay in bounds, complete the short passes, and put this game on ice. They'll go again with Bell. And he'll fight his way down right around the 12. Call it a gain of a couple, and that's going to leave him with a third and about five. Time for a break. We'll come back, see what transpires after this. One of the bigger plays in the game thus far, and the crowd getting into it as we come up on a big third down. It's a gain of six as they're able to convert, and now it's first and goal.
GG. Take some kneels.
Defense still with three timeouts. We'll see if they want to use them here as the kneel down comes.
If he'll use his timeouts, I mean, might as well, but I could miss the field goal. No, I think he knows it.
Defense still with three timeouts. We'll see if they want to use them here as the kneel down comes.
I believe he knows it.
And And back at the 8 now. Third and goal.
GG to my opponent.
A road win in the National Football League. Charles, you never take that for granted, no matter who you're playing, no matter where you're playing.
You take it and you run with it. And you know you primed the pump all week in your own home facility. No one thinks we can do this. Only people who believe are right here in this room. And then you go on the road, band together, and get it done.
So that'll do it for us. For my partner, Charles Davis, and all the hard-working men and women on our crew, I'm Brandon Gaughan. You've been watching the NFL right here on EA Sports. Till next time, we say so long from Charlotte.